Okay, if we work together, we can take that part.
But also thinks it's the worst thing ever.
Yeah.
Just like everybody else.
I think I've been a bit jaded in my process as a character on this show about love, but I think I've learned how to start falling in love with myself again. And that has really been quite key for Oscar.
Darcy knows how to receive love. That's really all she's interested in. She doesn't quite know how to give it, so she's working on that. Except for to anyone but Asta. Doesn't come naturally, but she's working on it.
I think Kate resented the love that she had in the beginning when you meet her in season one. Because, you know, it was love that made her come to patience and support Ben. And I think she starts resenting the fact that she, you know, has spread herself too thin or come to a place where she doesn't feel like she has any community. So, and then I think by the end of season three, it's like, because she's learned to love herself and receive love from people in town and make connections, she's more capable of giving and receiving love. And certainly she's got a lot more love to give in season four, hopefully, if I get my baby back, Darcy.
I can't, it's a cutie. It's a little baby, I like it.
Awesome.
Great question.
That's a magazine that we're all signing. It was in like a magazine rack in the toilet downstairs. It's been sitting in there for a while. I think that's a Deuce. Thank you. Sorry. I always just called it the Deuce Mag.
I mean, it's purpose in its name.
Exactly.
Right?
It's a motorcycle company. It has nothing to do with the con or anything.
Question over here. Yes?
It's okay. It's video tricks.
Yo, that's gross, man.
with you all, and I know we are all so ready to get to the good juice of this panel. I do have a couple quick announcements to make before we get started. I'm Stephanie, I'm gonna be your moderator today. You all saw the video showing that we're doing a hybrid live question and Discord question format. Mastermind, Knight of the Round Table, Minister of Silly Walks, and so much more. He is a legend of sketch and built the foundation of modern comedy, John Cleese! John
by Joe Biden impersonator.
Welcome to DragonCon. Raise your hand out there if it is your first DragonCon, because I know it's yours.
I'm having trouble listening to you because of the echo is considerable. Tell me again.
How many people out there is your first DragonCon?
Well, nobody's able to tell me why it's called DragonCon. Are there a lot of dragons around? Because I haven't seen any. It seems such a silly title.
Well, some mysteries of this world are left for another day. What do you say we start asking some questions and getting some answers?
I would be delighted to do exactly that.
All right, perfect. Let's start with our first person.
Hi, nice to meet you. Welcome to DragonCon. You have had an amazing, diverse, and long career, and I thank you for your life's work. Within that, are there any roles or concepts that were never realized but you wish had been?
Any concepts or projects that you've always wanted to make happen?
In the future?
Maybe.
Yes, I've got several, actually. You might be surprised. I mean, I imagine most of you know the Monty Python films. Yeah. Well, I'm adapting Life of Brian for the stage in London. And there was a big debate with me and the other Pythons about whether to finish it with the crucifixion scene. Which, you know, when we did that in 1988, it was hugely successful. People thought it was hilarious. Of course they did, but you know, 45 years later, it doesn't have the same impact. So I was trying to figure out, how can I end it in a different way? And I decided that I was going to have Pontius Pilate apologize for... ...crucifying Christ. I thought he would say things like, let's face it, mistakes were made. Let's move on into the sunny uplands. hindsight is always 20/20. So I'm working on that. I think we'll be doing that next year in London. And also, my daughter and I have been turning Fish Called Wanda into a musical. So we're going to do a showcase in London. The reason we're doing these shows in London is that if you put on a show in London, it costs about one quarter, 25% of what it would cost to put on in Broadway. So you put it on in London first, and then you hope if it's successful, it can get a transfer. But those are the two main things. I've also got a movie that I've written, and it's a light comedy about cannibalism.
Thank you. Enjoy DragonCon.
Oh, the cast of Resident
So. Writing this down.
Wow, look at you. You're so beautiful.
Which one?
Oh.
It's a general beauty happening here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh my God, DragonCon 2024. Sunday! That was my voice this morning when I woke up in bed. Happy not to just be on the floor.
Oh, they got you a hotel room finally?
This time, I was in a hotel room.
Congratulations.
Yeah, and it was mine.
Surprising.
Yeah.
Just a quick show of hands here. Whose first time is it at DragonCon on the panel? Celebrities, they're just like, no. Crazy. This is the best. What has been the highlight of your con so far?
Oh,
geez. Oh. This? Right here.
Not this. I mean, this is amazing. Seeing all you guys. Yeah. What the highlight is. Being around the greatest fans on earth.
Truly.
I think is what's the best. Yeah. I truly, truly love, you know, and I say nerds, but I don't want that to sound derogatory. I think people think that I'm being like, nerds. I love, if you want something done, right, give it to nerds.
Yeah.
You do everything, right? We don't do things half-assed. I learned about the carpet. I almost cried. I was like, they just do things the right way.
Yeah, I was just saying that I've been to New York Comic Con and San Diego Comic Con, and they're so business oriented.
Yeah,
and you know,
yeah.
No offense, but this
the
is commercial. The best con I've ever been. Absolutely. I hope you come back.
We were in a panel yesterday, and someone said to us, they said, well, we came for Alan. We started watching the show for Alan, and we stayed for the women.
Yeah! Who said that?
Oh. Sorry, Alan.
Just the name.
And we sent that video right to Corey Reynolds.
So I'm glad you brought up the like nerd aspect of this, right? I've heard a few interviews with y'all in different spaces, and I want to know, what are y'all nerdy about? Like, what is your thing?
Well, I have a picture of the three of us with Jonathan Frakes.
Woo!
And we're all crying.
Yeah. We met him
He's crying.
And he said he loved our show. Oh my God.
Full nerdy.
Yeah.
I have been a Star Trek fan as long as I can remember. I'm a Trekker, for those of you who, if you know, you know. I have a podcast. It's called Treks in the City. Whatever. Thanks, Alan. Alan's done it. But yeah, I love Star Trek. It's my favorite thing in the world. If you wanted this panel to be me talking about Star Trek, you'd be like yawning by hour four.
She knows everything.
I do. It's wonderful.
Twin Peaks.
Ooh.
Yes. Give me that cherry pie.
I am nerdy about Radiohead first and foremost. And yes,
really?
Okay.
You know what's up. I'm sorry, forever and ever. And then I've gotten into Sarah J. Maas's books. I read the entire Avatar series. I'm on book 4 of Throne of Glass, and I'm like very deeply ensconced in the Sarah J. Maas universe right now, so I'm super nerdy.
You got me to read it.
Well?
I think mine is, a lot of people have known this now, Yardsticks, which you didn't know this?
No.
Oh yeah, I did an interview not too long ago where I talked about it. I think I've done a couple now where they're like, what is your nerd thing? And mine is Yardsticks. I've been collecting them for a while. And they're very specific Yardsticks, not just any Yardsticks.
Okay.
But I got a really cool Yardstick cane that somebody brought me, which is gonna go in my collection.
What is it about the Yardstick that magnetizes
you? Great question.
I'd love to know.
Well, there's so many things. They're old. It used to be an advertising tool that people would, you go to a store and they'd be like, and here's our Yardstick, please take it home with you. And so you had their Yardstick and that was the thing you measured everything by. So there's a whole thing about measuring and the exactness of things or not, of them being...
I'm learning a lot about you.
I thought this was a bit.
Well, no, this is real. No, he's serious.
And so then you would also have these advertisements, and it's from shops that don't exist anymore. A lot of like these old appliance stores before the big box stores came in, you know, be like Dan's Appliances, and it's TVs, microwaves, and like all this stuff that you now would go to Best Buy for. Those used to exist, and they had their phone numbers, and some of the phone numbers are like 5, because they're that old. They have letters in them, they're like 37NJR, call me, we measure up to all our competition, and they always have those puns on them, and then some of them are like funeral homes / furniture sales.
Wow, that's smart.
And one of them I have is a invalid car service and funeral home. Because if you start at one part of the car, you just slowly move back. In the box.
Now I'm not sure if it's a bit anymore.
No, it is.
Back on the other side.
I have many. I have.
I'll pull this nearer and be nice and loud.
How was your first DragonCon?
Amazing. When I got in yesterday and I was in the taxi coming from the airport, I have never seen so many people in the most extraordinary cosplay. And there was a Spider-Man dangling off a wall of a random building that I don't think was anything to do with the con, but it looks amazing.
And you're here today. Would you like to, in the future, come back for a longer period of time? Because we would love.
I would say when we filmed it, it was the second block for me. So block, it's so interesting. It was the third episode to shoot that we aired. But it was we shot in blocks. So episode 1 and randomly, They Take You Away was shot at the same time. And then we shot episode 2 and episode 3, which was Rosa, in South Africa. So when we were there, it was it was a very emotional time because we'd only just started and we were in something that felt, you guys knew before me how special Doctor Who is and will continue to be. But it was at that point where we realized that it isn't, you know, we were having so much fun, but then with the storyline of the Rosa episode, that television can be so impactful and powerful. But when you're in it, all I remember thinking was that Vanette Robinson was doing the most extraordinary performance. And so when you just do scenes with other actors who can blow you away, that's the most magical thing in all the design element of it. But then in watching it, as part of that, what I thought was so incredible was Sagan, the composer's music, but also the song choices that were used within that episode to really elevate it. And all, it felt very special when we watched it, because it was, I just feel like everybody's work shone, but then also it kind of introduced people, younger children, I think, to a moment in history that they for a younger audience might not have known about, which is, you know, essential everyone does. And I think that that was beautiful that television can do that. I don't know if that answers the question. I'm such an old roundabout. We're really good mates. We spend, you know, we keep going to South Africa. We're so bloody lucky. So we're filming there, we're filming back in Cardiff, we're doing all this fun stuff. And then in the last few days of that episode shooting, he did the scene where he reveals himself on the plane. And it was mind-bogglingly amazing. That's a terrible sentence, but we all kind of went, what? And that was the moment when I realized, I'm going to get upstaged in every scene. There was one bit, you know, there was one episode, I can't remember, oh God, it's all so blurry, I can't remember what episode it was now, but I just was mute, and I wasn't able to speak, and he got this amazing monologue, and I was like, oh my God, I felt like I was in a masterclass, just like, I was supposed to be like acting, kind of like, oh, but I was like going, oh my God, and even like the clapper loader, like one of the camera loaders came over to him and was just like, that was like the best thing I've ever seen. And he's a top bloke. Most importantly, he's a top bloke.
So, Jello Shot Queen, are you here?